Welcome to the series of 1 to 100 on Primavera Project Portfolio Management. This series of videos will explain how we create portfolio management system within Primavera P6. So everything we do here in creating schedules or creating ID or anything, it's related to the portfolio, the overall process, procedures, and governance of the portfolio. So I will start with the concepts for the beginners. So starting from scratch, I created a new database, which has nothing, just a clean database. So we understand what's going on. And when we see this from 1 to 100, it will show a lot of developments. The first things in Primavera is asking us about the industry, which we can change it later from admin preference. Let's keep it as it is now. And let's open the software. As any software, it has menus, tools, and it has windows for whatever you are doing inside. In Primavera here, we have this view, which includes the projects view and enterprise project structure. As you see here, there is no projects, just zero. We have here the columns, can change them. There is lot of choices. You can do whatever you want here. Many choices, and you can add yours also. You can specify any data related to this EPS and projects. You might have one EPS for your organization. It might be a government, it might be a company, any organization. So an EPS, you might have one EPS, we might have two, three, four, as you want. And within the EPS, there is small nodes for another EPS and portfolios like this. So this is the view you see when you open Primavera. Projects inside the enterprise project structure. In the right, you have the Gantt charts, which is a graph and charts showing the project line or project's activities with certain scale and time scale view. You can do per month, year, quarter, quarter, month, month, week, month, day, even to the shift and hour. There is big potentials. There is a big facilities within Primavera. So it's good to use it for anything. In the other window, we have the project data, which we have to enter in the beginning of the project, including from the date, start, finish, which is a simple thing, and the data date, which is what is this data date you are entering it. General, there is advanced things with calculations, settings, resources, codes, funding, budget summary, spending plan, budget log, notebook. There is a lot of things we do, but step by step. Here, it's just an entrance to understand what is there in Primavera P6. Notice that we are using the professional version, which is very simple comparing to the EPPM and web-based version. So this is the start. As I said, this is a beginner stage. So we'll make it simple, step by step, until we get to the expert ones. However, for whatever we do, it is about portfolio management. It's not just creating schedules. Most of the videos online, it's about creating schedules, some tricks, some tips there and there, not considering how we create a system. And this is maybe the start of creating a system from A to Z. I hope I can do it from 1 to 100. Please subscribe to the channel and visit us to www.galaxyeppm.com for more blogs and more videos. Also on our channel, Galaxy EPPM and YouTube. Most welcome. If you have any comments and if you have any requirements or questions, please add it to the YouTube video. Thank you very much and follow us for the next ones. Thank you.